Hello, my name is Sai. Welcome to Guitar Club Online. In this video, we're going to be learning the melody to the Pink Panther. That's the bit that goes. This bit's going to go along with the bass and the chords in the other videos, which you can learn. We're also going to cover the second section, which people don't usually cover. All that stuff is coming right up, so stick with us and we're going to get right into it. Pause the video now and you'll get to see how the numbering system works. Right, so we have a little few tinkly notes first, which is quite simply from the top to bottom, three notes, 14, 16, 12, quite a spread but quite high up, so the frets are small. All at once, there's various variations on this. You could have different notes spread up, I chose those three. And then we have some slide up bass line sort of power chords. So what we have is a 4 and a 6 here, playing a fifth apart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 6 and 4, sliding up to 7. That's 4 on the A string, 6 on the D string. I prefer to play this with my first finger and my third finger. You slide up to 7, then you move up to 6 and 8, and you slide that up to 9, 7 and 9. All together, that goes along with the bass line. Move the first finger to 7 on the E string, and then open string, which can also be a small power chord, 0 on the E string, 2 on the A. Then what happens is we do that in reverse, down to 3 from the 8-6. And we go 3-3, so this is copying kind of what the bass line's doing. All together. That's taking you up to an E minor chord. Down to a C9. So that's the introduction. This also happens towards the end. That's kind of one of the most well-known parts of the piece. And then we get into the main melody, which is the same walk up with our fingers. 4, 5, 6, 7. And this happens before the beat. So like with the intro, I'll just count that in. So it goes 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So it happens like that, and the same with this. Happens after the third beat. 1, 2, 3. Now I like to use all four fingers here, and I'll show you why. So if you have all four here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 4 and 5. Going to go down a string, four, five, six, seven, four, five, then down a string and 5, 4. So it's all, you've all got all these numbers crammed in together. It looks really confusing at first. If you keep these to the four and five, first finger, middle finger to the fourth and fifth fret, third finger, little finger to the 6th and 7th fret, then you don't have to change or move around your hand at all, it's just your fingers. Down the string, back up to the A string, down the string, down the string. And then they're still in position to do this. Just 7 on the A string, then take that off and middle finger on the 5th fret on the D string. First finger, 4th fret on the G string. And that just goes downwards. 4, 3. And I do a pull off there, so I'm playing 2 on the G string, off. And if you move that, when you play the 2, if you move it slightly and take it off, it'll play the open string. You might want to practice that. It's quite a common technique. You can move that around as well, so 2, 0, then to the D string. So I'll play that whole sequence for you slowly. Down the string, up the string, down, down again, rake them across, take it down, pull off. Then we go back up. Same again. Seven and five, same notes again. This time we jump down to the B string. So that's the second time that melody is played. And then we go to an F chord. Well, the other guitar goes to the F chord, as you'll see in the other video. There is a little diminished trick you can use here, which I'm just going to show you quickly. Which is this note, if you put your little finger on 5, 4, 5, 4. Actually, reorder that, so that's the middle finger, little finger, middle finger, third finger, first finger, that's the bottom 4. Now if you take this up 4 frets, 4 frets, 4 frets, it's the same notes in a different order, and it sounds very cool. I didn't do this in the other video I did. This is just an extra little trick you can throw in. And we go back to the beginning and repeat that section again. This time, the second time of this, you go. So that's. I did just put a hammer on it, and you can do this, but the easy version is 5, 3, 4, 2, 0, 2. So 5, 3, B string, 4, 2, 0 on the G, ending up with the 2 on the D. Hammer on. Pause the video anytime if you need to, I'm trying to not take too long on this. 3, 2, which repeats 4 times, so it's G string 3 to a 2. I do a pull off there, so I play the 3. I'm already holding the 2 down the entire time. 3, pull off to 2. And then this repeats 3 times. It's a 0 on the G, 2, 0, 2 on the A. With the E minor chord. And then we get ready for the next section. This beautiful chord you can learn about in the other video. So I hope that's all clear to you. Any questions about that, ask me below. And we're on to section 2, which is my favourite section, which is really fun to work out. So we're going to bar the bottom 4 strings. So making sure we put our thumb up, put our thumb behind along the middle, right in the middle of the neck. Keep this part of our hand quite low. We don't want to put it up here, which is what a lot of people tend to get into doing. So keep it low, and you've got a nice big gap under here. You pinch those 4 strings in with a flat first finger on the second fret. And we want to keep this held in because we're going to push it up a fret whilst keeping it in. Which is a nice little chord melody we've got going on in this next section. This section is called Section C on the sheet. Please download the PDF and follow along. And then we have a different shape. Which is first finger on the bottom string, 5th, 5, little finger on 7. You might know this kind of shape as a C7 shape. If you can play a C down here, and your little finger on the G string on the 3. We're ignoring ignoring both E strings, we're not playing anything on them. 3, 2, 1. Ah, 3, 2, 3, 1. Now if we take that down a string and move it along. First finger, little finger on the 7, middle finger on 6, third finger on 7. And again, we're going to play that. Sounds wrong at the moment because we're going to move it up one fret. So we're just still on the bottom four strings. And then we jump this whole shape up. Two more frets to 8. 8 at the bottom. 10 at the top, slide it up to 11. So all together, 2, 3. Really nice melody together. Not quite sure my guitar's in tune, I can't really hear that though. And then we're on 13, middle finger, on the bottom E string here. 13, 14, 12. Then we're going to bar the 8. So again, pause this at any point and look what's on screen and look what I'm telling you. We're barring 3 strings on the 8 and our pinky, our little finger, is going on the 11. This is doing nothing, this middle finger. I actually prefer to put my middle finger down there that I can just pull off with the little finger. Bit of a strange shape to hold at first. This section is well worth learning, but maybe for a more advanced guitarist. I'm definitely sure you can stick it out. I've taught a lot of people this. So altogether that's... Hold it down, pull off. Which is jumping to a sort of B-flat minor chord. So we're going to bar the 8th fret. The 6th fret, sorry, that's the 5th, 6th. And you're going to put your 3rd finger on your D string on the 8. 8, 6, 6, 6. So that 2nd bit of the C section goes. There we go. All together. 2, 3. Move to single note melody, which is again really nice. 8 with our little finger. I prefer doing this with a little finger. You could do it with first finger. I prefer to spread my hand out. You might want to go. So 8 on the B string and the E string. 5, 6, 5, 8. So a little hammer-on, and then if you're doing a hammer-on, hold the 5 down the whole time, hammer the 6 on and pull it off. If you move your finger down when you pull off, you make the string below ring out. 8, 5, 8, end on the 8. Then move that up 2 frets, do exactly the same. 11, 8, hammer 9. Oh! There we go, so. Fairly easy. Straight to octaves. Now you could do this single notes, so just read what's on the sheet there. I quite like doing nice octaves when it's possible. So here we have, an octave is the same note but one low and one high. So here we have a 5 on the A string, which is actually a D note, and here is a higher D note. You hear how they're the same? And that is a 7 on the G string. So we've got one fret string in between that's not being used. That one. And you can strum them. If you mute the other strings, you can strum. You can use your fingers. So move that around, you can see on the sheet. When we go down, we get to 3 and 6, because with our whole thing, when we tune the guitar and it goes 5, 5-0, 5-0, and then 4-0, it means we displace by one note this octave. We have to go 2 frets apart, 3 frets apart. So that's 5 and 7 with the string in the middle, then 3 and 6. Where's that? So, 3 of these. Actually, 4 of those. I do a little slide down on that one. And that's that octave section. It's all very fiddly, this. It's great to just take a little segment of it and work on those two bars and then move on to the next one. And we get onto another single melody again. So you go 8, 6, 8, 9, 9. Quite a bluesy lick there. So we're just on the B string. And then we go back to this, what I'm going to call a 7 shape here. So that C7 shape, slid up. To our G minor, I'm going to go over that. Now, I'm not sure if I did this in the original video, but there's a really cool way. Instead of going like this shape, which is 6, 8, 7, 8, you can actually put this 7 as a 9, and it's got a really cool sound. I actually think this, I prefer that sound. I can't remember if I did it in the original video or not. Down to that minor shape we had before, but this time on the 3rd fret, so bar the 3 or 4 strings on the 3, and put your 3rd finger on the D string on the 5. And then we've got a last little section. Same 7 shape, we just keep using that. And the same minor shape. I'm strumming down 3 strings, missing out the E string, because I'm doing that on an upstroke. I'm not letting them ring out either. Okay, I hope that's helpful. Again, any questions, just slow this down and go through bit by bit. Next we have the guitar solo, which I'm not really gonna go into too much detail about. Basically, you want to be playing in E minor, an E minor blues, or you could put a bit of G major in there. So your E minor pentatonic is this shape here. So pause it when it comes on the screen and it'll help you learn it. So I'm using my 3rd finger for 3rd fret, 1st finger for 1st fret. Down and up with the pick. 3-0, 3-0, 2-0, 2-0, 2-0, 3-0. And now pause that and have a look at that. And then next is the blues scale. So for the guitar solo, I just kind of improvised that on the spot. I wasn't even going to throw the solo section in. And then I remembered it was in the original, so. So those extra bluesy notes are nice as pull-offs and hammer-ons, or bends. You can play around with that a bit, pause those shapes, as I said, to learn them. I may well do another video on soloing techniques for songs. And after that, let me just see on the sheet, we go straight back to the intro walking up again. That power chord shape we had going on. Repeats twice. And we repeat the whole melody until the end when we get to this really nice chord. Which is the same shape as the chord down here. So here we have a... Let me get a bit closer. First finger on 14. 14, 16, 16, 17. Bottom four strings. My little finger's playing the 17 on the D string. 17. Put the open E in there. Slide it down if you wish. So I hope you've enjoyed that and you can now play a bit of the Pink Panther melody. Feel free to download the PDF, print it out, and work on that, and play along with the uploaded video of all the guitar parts. Any requests for new pieces below, and I'll see you on the next video at Guitar Club Online. Thanks for watching.